On this edition of Big Deke News, we are going to go over the Steelers ratings that we have not gone over yet to show exactly why EA and the Madden developers have absolutely no clue what they're doing. Let's begin. Let's go over running backs. This one's really easy. Najee Harris, Steelers premier running back. They have as the 15th best in the game at an 85 overall, which is stupid in and of itself because I think worst case scenario, he's a top 10 running back, objectively. But we don't have to get into what he did last year because I've went over that multiple times on the podcast and on this show. But what he did last year with a weak offensive line is pretty damn impressive. But what makes matters worse is they don't even have him in the top 10 amongst running backs for the ability to break tackles. And if you watched Najee Harris last year, that's basically all he did. Here's what Najee himself had to say about it on Rich Eisen yesterday.
You know, they didn't even put me in a top 10 for breaking tackles. And I was like, wait, okay, hold on now. Okay, let's get something straight here. I broke a lot of tackles.
So it seems like EA has already royally messed up most of the Steelers' key ratings. TJ, we talked receivers with Claypool, Muth, and now Najee. I mean, they can't possibly do any more damage, right? Well, that's where you're wrong, because you can never count out EA for continuing to do the wrong thing. Because when you look at the safety ratings, they have Minkah Fitzpatrick as the 11th best overall safety in the NFL at an 89 overall, behind Jamal Adams at a 90 overall. It leaves you speechless. It really does. Minkah is a top three safety, no debate. Not talking about this anymore. Moving on. But in the safeties category, they did give Terrell Edmonds a 78 overall, which isn't terrible. I do think he should be rated at least in the 80s, but I thought they were going to give him like a 74 or a 75, so I'll take a 78. It's sad we're getting to the point where we could celebrate, or maybe not celebrate, but just say, hey, this is okay when Madden gets a rating somewhat wrong, because we know how much worse it could actually be. Where's the standard at?
That's the standard.
But here's where we hit the point where it all makes sense. Madden developers literally don't watch football. Obviously, we talked about some of the ratings from around the league. Cooper Kupp not being a 99, TJ Watt's rating, and also Ja'Marr Chase at an 87. But we need to go no further than the newly revealed Steeler ratings to understand that, wow, they literally don't watch the sport that they're making a video game out of. First, we'll get into overall ratings. They have Alex Highsmith at a 75 and Larry Ogunjobi at a 75. But then they have Devin Bush at a 77. Trust me, I'm 100% fine with them giving Devin Bush a 77. They also gave him a 90 speed because that just helps out the virtual Steelers. But in no world can you tell me that Devin Bush had a better season than Alex Highsmith and Larry Ogunjobi last year. Just more evidence that the Madden developers don't know football, but this is where it gets really bad. Madden 23 has Steelers linebacker Robert Spillane with 88 speed. He ran a 4.77 40. So that means whenever you drop these quarterback ratings tomorrow, Kenny Pickett better have at least 90 speed, at least if you're going to have Robert Spillane at an 88 running a 4.77 40, because Kenny Pickett ran a 4.73. Keep it consistent. Obviously, I'm not mad about Spillane's speed because, again, just like Devin Bush's rating, this helps out the Steelers in the virtual world. But this is just another example to prove Madden and their developers' incompetence. Let's go over some of the other speed ratings and compare them to Spillane. Anthony Miller at an 88 speed, the exact same speed as Spillane. But he ran, some of the reports online are saying a 4.4, 4.4, 4.5, something like that. TJ Watt, 83 speed. He ran a 4.69. So he ran a better 40 than Spillane, but has a less speed rating. Gunnar Olszewski has an 88 speed, the same exact as Spillane, but he ran a 4.56. Demonte Kazee, 87 speed, one worse than Spillane. 4.5 speed. Trey Norwood, 87 speed, one less than Spillane. 4.58 speed. And last one, Najee Harris. We already went over his overall rating, but they also gave him an 88 speed, the same as Robert Spillane. Spillane ran the 4.77, as we mentioned, but Najee Harris ran a 4.45 40 at the combine last year. Make it make sense, please. It's clear Madden's lack of football knowledge is on display, but before we close out, I'm going to go over just some of the other ratings that they gave for the Steelers up to this point that may be of note or may be of interest to you guys. So Miles Jack, they have it an 82 overall. That's tied for ninth amongst middle linebackers, so that's not terrible. DeMarvin Leal at a 68 overall, maybe could be a little bit higher. Chris Boswell, 82 overall, that's fifth overall amongst kickers. Again, this goes back to my sentiment where I'm saying, like, yeah, that's bad, but it could be worse, so I'm not going to be that mad about it. I think he should be top two or three, but at the same time, I wouldn't have been shocked if they had Boswell as, like, the seventh or eighth best kicker, or even just outside the top 10 completely, because, again, Madden. Let me know if we should even react to these anymore. Well, who are we kidding? We know we're going to react to the next batch that comes out. The thing is, how much worse can it get? Because we've already gone into these with low expectations. Now I think we should go into the next ratings reveal with the lowest of expectations possible. Because the only question is, how worse can it get? How much lower can they drop the bar? Because what's next? Cam Hayward being 88 overall? Kevin Dotson not being in the 99 overall club? We'll have to wait and see. But that's it for this edition of Big Deke News. Hope you guys enjoyed. Let me know what you guys think of these Madden 23 ratings. They just keep getting worse and worse. But that's it. Stay chilling. Peace.